In my last video, I took a look at a Micro ATX chassis that, in all honesty, was a great, great value, coming in at around $60-ish, and that's the version with all of the fans included, the ARGB fans, no less. It was a really, really good deal. It had great airflow, it had a lot of premium features that I would expect on a more expensive case, but it was coming in at a price that is very, very budget friendly. So I put together a system in that build, and that's the system we're gonna be looking at today. Today's build was put together with a lot of parts that I just sort of had laying around. So we are featuring a Z87 platform. That's with an Intel i7-4770K. Now, I ran this CPU at completely stock settings, and the reason for that is just simply because I'm also running with one of those terrible Intel coolers. Like, this thing doesn't cool anything, and the CPU is likely to run as hot as the sun to begin with, so we are just leaving everything at stock. Though, if you have a similar configuration but with a better cooler, you can get quite a bit of headroom out of these Haswell i7s, or at least the unlocked Haswell chips, as there obviously are locked chips that you can't really get anything extra out of, but that's beside the point. We are running with DDR3 memory. Obviously, that's going to be running at much lower speeds than DDR4 memory comes in at. In this particular case, we're looking at 1600 megahertz across a dual channel configuration. That's a 2x4 kit. So 8 gigabytes total, 1600 megahertz, absolutely nothing special there. The GPU in question is an RX 470, which I purposely picked off of my shelf because it meets the minimum specification to run Cyberpunk. So I was curious to see how that would run in this system compared to back when I looked at the 8350 running with an RX 470 in this title. Now the game's been updated slightly as well, so I was really crossing my fingers for slightly better performance in general. And then the storage solution was just a SATA based SSD, so we have pretty quick load times on all the titles. That's not really going to impact the actual frame rates in most cases, but just so you're fully aware. So today we're leading off in the way that we normally do, and that's with Fortnite for these benchmarks on the low preset at 1080p. So an average FPS of 161, a 1% low there of 100, and that 0.1% low there dipping below 60 down clear to 50 FPS, obviously you'd like to see that a little bit higher, but anecdotally speaking, this was, again, a very smooth experience as we would expect with this configuration and Fortnite. So not just playable, but actually a really nice experience with this title. Our other multiplayer focused title here is going to be Call of Duty Warzone, and this is on low settings at 1080p. So an average FPS here of 83, a 1% low of 59, and a 0.1% low of 48. And once again, we have a really nice experience here overall. Obviously, it is dipping a little bit below that 60 FPS mark in the 1% and 0.1% lows, but it wasn't in such a way that was detracting from the experience in any meaningful way whatsoever. So I would say that with this particular configuration, you could not just have a good experience, but also be very competitive in these types of titles. And then we move over to single player focus games, and Borderlands 3 on the medium preset at 1080p also gives a really nice experience and also some consistency with those frame times. So the average FPS here was 68, the 1% low was just down to 54, and 0.1% low was there at 45. So if you are seeking out 60 FPS, then you may have to lower settings a little bit further to really get a consistent 60 FPS here. But you are seeing really good frame times and frame rates in general with this hardware configuration in this particular title. It was overall a similar story with Red Dead Redemption 2. However, I will say the 1%, 0.1% lows are a little bit harsher with this particular title. So I saw a little bit less frame time consistency here. Still, that average frame rate was hitting the 61 mark. So you are hitting a mostly consistent 60 FPS here. But again, if you need to actually hit that mark more consistently, your option here becomes to drop down resolution a little bit more. The 1% and 0.1% lows, though, were still above 30 FPS. So even when you're hitting a little bit of a frame time issue, you're still not dropping down to slideshow perspective here with these frame rates maintaining that 40-ish mark instead of dropping clear down into the 20s. And finally, the title that I was actually building this PC up with in mind, just because I wanted to try it out. Knowing that the RX 470 is the minimum spec on the GPU side of things, Cyberpunk 2077 came in with an average frame rate of 39, a 1% low there of 28, and a 0.1% low of 23. And this is where it gets a little bit anecdotal from my perspective on whether or not this title is playable, because at a 28 FPS for your 1% low, you are definitely gonna notice a little bit of stuttering as you get into a harder to run section of the game, or just potentially a firefight in the game where lots of things are happening. The frame rate definitely does dip below 30 FPS. However, I will also say that by and large, I wasn't seeing a whole lot of major dips down into the low 20s, though a couple of them were there. So I would say, just based on my gameplay here, that it was in fact a playable title with the RX 470 and the i7-4770K, but it is definitely not an optimal way of playing this title. In fact, if I were running this title with this hardware configuration, I would drop down to like 900p to just get myself just a little bit of extra frames in those areas where the game gets very difficult to run. But it is definitely, I would say, playable. But like I said, it's not the configuration you want to be playing Cyberpunk 2077 on if you're at 1080p settings. So overall, this makes a really nice little starter PC. It's got a really nice case with it. It's got a solid power supply that you can drop in a nice GPU upgrade into it. It has a platform that's basically dead end, but the good news is an i7-4770K paired with a more powerful GPU will actually give you some really nice performance, even in games like Cyberpunk 2077, where we were definitely GPU bottleneck there. The CPU could have definitely handled more out of that particular situation than the RX 470 could give it. So there is a little bit of life left in a platform like this that's on these Haswell i7s in particular. They still give you 4 cores and 8 threads to work with, and the vast majority of games out there right now will still run just fine on 4 cores and 8 threads, especially if you can overclock it a little bit, provided that you give it the GPU power it needs to actually run the title, which an RX 470 right now is really pushing the limits of whether or not Cyberpunk 2077 can run on it. Though at 900p, you could probably scratch out a few extra frames, at which point I would say it's much more towards the consistently playable experience than it would be with 1080p settings. But those are just my thoughts on this particular rig. Let me know in those comments down below if you have a similar hardware configuration, especially one of these lower hardware configurations with Cyberpunk in particular. I'm curious how your system runs this game, so let us know that in those comments down below. And of course, if you like this video and you want to see more like it, give it a like, share, subscribe, and comment. All those things are very helpful for the channel. You can follow me both on Instagram and on Twitter at Hoosier Hardware. And as always, I'll let YouTube queue up a couple more videos from my channel for you to watch. I'm Shane with Hoosier Hardware, and I'll see you guys in the next video.